Hello, my friends, and welcome back for my fourth tutorial here on YouTube. I'm happy you're with me. I'm excited to present this painting for you. It's a pretty cool backlit painting deep in the forest with a lot of sunlight coming through and some waterfalls. Had a lot of fun putting it together. So paint along with me or just watch and enjoy and have fun. And you can see how I created this painting. So let's get to it, and I will see you on the other side. Hey, everybody. I hope you are all doing well. Thanks for tuning in and giving me a watch here. By all means, please hit the subscribe button. And I'm going to tell you what I got going on here, and then we'll get started. So the first thing I've done, I have a 16 by 20 canvas. And I took some black gesso. Use this natural sponge, just dabbed it in on a plate, then came up here and just basically just gobbed it in there. All these little background things are all part of this, just from the sponge here. So we put all that pattern in all the way down, and a little heavier here, obviously, and some heavier spots. Dark in the middle, probably put a little stream, I think, a couple tiny little waterfalls, nothing major. A lot of foliage, some big trees, and of course all these background trees we did with some foam applicators. Again, just getting them wet with the gesso and all the time, everything. Just real easy way to do a bunch of trees and make it look like it's deep in a forest. So we're going to do a backlit type painting with some light coming in from here. Not quite sure exactly what colors we're going to use, but I can say for sure we're going to use some yellow, some Indian yellow, and so this is some transparent red, which will be nice on the mix with the ochre. So after I put the gesso in, I've got one coat, a thin coat of clear gel by Gamblin. You can use Bob Ross liquid clear. That's just as good. This is Gamblin clear gel, I prefer this, but either one works. This is non-toxic. So anyways, so we got a good coat of that on there. Just one thin coat, not too much. And now we're going to get started. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is go into some CAD yellow here. Got a couple little piles because we'll need a bit of it for later too. So just into some CAD yellow. Make sure you can see that. There we go. So just tap the bristles in there. Make sure it's not gobbed on in any particular spots. All right, then we'll come up here. I think we're going to have our sun a little off center, maybe peering through this little piece right here. So we'll come right here. Don't worry about the colors going over the dark trees. We can, most of it will show through, and whatever doesn't, we can darken. So we're going to come right in here. That's going to be our bright spot. And as you can see already, the colors against the gesso patterns is really cool looking. So not too much, maybe about like that. Let's spin that down. Maybe it comes through here. Maybe a little more. Get that yellow kind of spilling through. And all these different spots. More color. Maybe it comes through here. That's where light's coming down. Some spots where it's wandering through. Just here and there, wherever you'd like. It's kind of neat when you leave these holes back here. It almost looks like when you put the yellow in between, or any color, it's almost leafy. So there we go. Excellent. You can use circles, whatever you'd like. Just get the color in there. Okay, very nice. Now we're going to come into some of this Indian yellow. So we'll just pull some of that Indian yellow out. Don't have to clean the brush. Tap it in there so we get a nice even distribution of paint. So there's no globs. Never go right into the big pile and pull. Just pull out a touch and then tap it like crazy. Okay, so we're going to kind of come around this nice golden color. More color. I need a little more than that. Tap. This Indian yellow is transparent as well, but if you put it on too heavy, it will get a little foggy on you. So just be careful. We're just going to throw it in here and there. Looking away across. It'll eat up your yellow too, so be careful with it. I kind of like to go a little at a time. All right, very good. And then we're going to come into that transparent red. And again, tap it. Go with a little bit at first. Just a little bit at first. I dropped this on the edges. Yeah, look at that. Very pretty. Like that. A little more. Yeah, go get yourself some of this transparent red. It's good stuff. Especially on these black gesso canvases. Oops, a little heavy there. It's all right. Let's go over here. You'll come and steal some of this and bring it over here. Crosses a little bit. I like that. We can even mix some of that with the ochre too. So a little ochre and a little of that transparent red. We'll work this out here. This is kind of covering my tree, but we can redefine the tree. That's no big deal. Easy to do. And then some of this transparent red will spill over here. Keep the yellow. And darker here in the corner. Color. A real cool look to it. All right, very good. Very nice. Okay. Now I'm going to come back with my little blender. With that blender brush, I'm going to add a little more yellow to the center. Yellow this out. And then we're going to work our way out and just kind of blend these edges down. Just blend these edges down. Yeah. Yellow pop through a little bit. Seen already. See, it looks like little. Kind of like little red leaves and stuff. Okay, very good. And when you're painting these things, always step back. Very important when you're painting. Standing here, it gives you one look. You got to drop back 5-10 feet and take a peek. Might even add just a little bit, titanium white in the middle. I'm coming to a little bit of titanium white in the middle, just to add it a little bright spot there. Brush off, take some of this down a little bit. There we are. Very good. And then we can kind of zing some rays through here. There, kind of fuzzy look. Very good. I'm going to go back with this paper towel and wipe down some of these little white spots. Just get a little darker. All right, so the next thing we're going to do is put our little stream in. Get that in place, and then we can build around it. So let's do that. And for that, we will get a small fan brush. All right, we're going to start with a very small fan brush. And we're just going to go straight into some white. Not a lot, just a little bit. Literally, just taking some of this that's left on the canvas here, on the palette. Just a little bit of white. So we're gonna come from behind this tree. We're gonna bring it down this way and then this way. So I wanna start a little lower than I have here. So maybe right here. Just kind of back and forth. It's gonna go behind that tree and then come this way. I'll tell you what, you know what I'm gonna do? Let's put a little waterfall right here. So right here, there we go. Just a little dumper right there. Then that'll come down. It's going to come this way. And then maybe right here. Don't overdo these waterfalls. Just something like that. That's about all you need. Okay, and then you come underneath. Just a little, not too much in the splashes. Just a little bit, because it's a small waterfall. So then maybe that comes over here. Again, just kind of leave some of these darks. It's very important. I'm going to go up here and fill in some of these darks as well. Maybe this boy comes around, comes over to here, and then down. Okay, and then maybe this guy came this way a little bit. Like, this way comes down right there. They kind of meet up. Some light splashies, not much. And then this boy will run down. Maybe goes off that way. We'll see. We'll have a little rock that comes over him. Not too much on the splashies. These are short drops here. It's not big drops. And then you can kind of tick up a couple spots here that maybe little splashies going on. There. And that's about all we need for our water for now. All right. I think I'm going to dump one more little waterfall right here. That's about all we need. A couple little splashies, and it's in the distance, so I like that. It looks good. Maybe a couple splashies in, just a little bit. Just push a couple times. That's all. That's all I need. Literally just pushing up a little bit on the fan brush. Gives you those little splashy looks. All right. Okay, I've added a little bit of burnt umber and dark sienna, and we're going to take some white and put some rocks in around the waterfall, and again, then we'll build our way out. So I like to use, I think I'll use a palette knife for this. So we're going to take some of that sienna, and a little bit of the umber. Mix that together. Toss a little white in there. Very good. And maybe even a little bit of. Let me get some ochre. One moment. Plop a little ochre. Sometimes when I paint, I like to only put the colors out that I need thus far in the painting. And then add them as I go. Because sometimes I don't know what I'm going to do. So anyway, so we have that. We're going to put, again, a little bit of this ochre in there too. Kind of make a nice rocky color. And leave it very marbled in appearance. We want these streaks. Okay, so we're gonna maybe back here further. We're just gonna take the small edge of our knife and just get a little bit of paint. Just a touch. So let's go over here. And we're just gonna highlight a little bit of what would be the top of a rock. And we're just touching that. Okay, we've got a little rock there. Leave a little dark. Come below that a little bit. And just kind of shape that down. Okay. Maybe over here. Get a little flatter here, closer to the shoreline. I'm also going to put a little bit of dark mix, some mountain mix, which is just a combination of the darks. We'll need more of that later. Come into a little bit of that dark. Just get a little bit on the edge of your knife. I'm just going to touch up some of these areas. These little dark. There we go. That's better. Right here. And again, this is far off. I'm not too worried about that. But just to add a little bit of shadows in here. Darker down there. Very good. And a little dark on this side. I'm just adding some dark in where I thought it was a little bit too bright. All right, very nice. Now we'll go to this. We're going to go to this other side up here and do the same thing. We're just going to drop a little bit of rock in. and it's far off, so we don't have to get too detailed with it. Maybe here. Let's come in with some dark. A little heavy. Good. That's good. Again, it's so far off, you really don't have to worry about that too much. Maybe right here on the other side of this tree. We'll cut that off with the tree, so we're not too worried about that. Good. All right, where else? Let's see. Maybe we've got some a little bit flat here. Maybe this comes out a little bit into the water. Maybe this dips down. I like that. Leave these dark areas in here. And then feel free to go back and again, drizzle some dark, especially on this shadow side, if you didn't get enough in there. Okay, very good. Keep moving forward. Let's say these rocks continue. Maybe this one comes down like this. We're going to put some dark in there too. It's a little bright. More dark, darker brown color. Just kind of jiggle this in. All right, I'm going to darken the top of this a little bit. Actually, get some brown. Just drizzle. Just real gently over the top. Just to get a little more dark in there. And you can piddle with your rocks all day. I mean, you could use a filbert brush. A fan brush makes really cool rocks. There we go. But a filbert makes great rocks. All right. Very good. Let's come over to this other side. Right here. We're just grazing this. Something like that. Very good. And I'm going to darken this up right here. Behind that tree is going to be a little darker. All right, I'm just going to go back and touch up a couple of these areas with a little dark. There we go. So you got to step back and look at it. See where maybe it's a little too bright. Add some dark. shadow on this side. Oops. Oops. All right, good. Okay. A little brighter on this side, the light's hitting. It's a little darker here. We got this tree in front of us. Sorry, forgot to turn my camera on. I'm just blending more of this yellow out. My bad. Blend some of that yellow out. There. Very good. All right, so we're going to go into some straight yellow. Maybe touch a little bit of this red. Just a little bit. And we're going to smash the fan brush open. Just so we get lots of hair sticking out here. And then we're going to come up in here. Just kind of touch. More color. Just highlight a little bit of these that are further back. There we go. Keep moving forward a little bit. Maybe we'll get a little bit darker. So come forward, add a little bit of that transparent red in there. And again, really mush out that fan brush so that it splays out. Who knows, maybe the color changes a wee bit here. Cool. Let's see here. Maybe here we're going to go a little more into the red, transparent red, and the yellow ochre. Maybe it's a little darker through here. Okay, that's in the background over there. Then maybe here, coming off the top, maybe a little darker. Back here, too bright, let's get rid of that. There we are. So see that, we'll darken that up, maybe put a little brown in it, just a little bit. It's always good sometimes to tap that brush on the on your palette or on a paper towel to get the excess paint off. So we're just going to have some floaters back here, kind of out of the distance, hard to see. And a couple of these will cross over. We'll put a couple over the trunk later. Okay, very nice. Let's come over to this other side. Maybe back in here. more yellow. Just a little yellow. Come up here. Let's see what we got. A little darker back here. Good. Interesting. Kind of digging the colors. More of the red, and I'm just kind of going back and forth between the ochre, the transparent red, just for some nice couple back here. Distance. All right, maybe even come in here, touch a couple spots, a little straight yellow, just to bring out a couple of these little edges. Maybe do the same thing on this side, just a little bit. A couple spots with that yellow's peeking through. All right, very good. Some bushes up front. And again, just some spots here and there. There we go. All right, I think I'm going to come in here, punch in a little dark, a little too bright here. There we go. That's better. Punch a little dark in. That's better. Yeah, a little more depth. And I'm going to come back. Just touch up a couple of these spots. A little more bright yellow. A little color variation in there. Very good. All right, I think we'll leave it. Couple more spots. Very good. All right, so now we're going to take our 1-inch brush and our liquid white. Let's see what we're going to do here. Maybe a little ochre. And a little bit of that Indian yellow, yellow ochre. Pull that out. All right, so we're going to make this a nice goldish color. We're going to just tap that the bristles into the paint. Let me get a little more of this paint. Okay. Tap, 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 and when you get that little bush in the paint, that's what you got on your bristles. So tap it and get a nice distribution of paint. And then we're going to come up here, we're going to fill this bush in. So a nice rounded top. Touch, touch, touch. Okay, just like that. A nice bush head. Back into that color, tap, 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 tap. And we'll continue it here. Round it back this way. Tap more color. Maybe we'll go in a little more of the red. Just to change this up a wee bit. Very good. We're going to add a little yellow to that same color, so we'll dip through the yellow and then come back over here just to lighten it up a little bit. A little more sunshine color. Okay. Again, tap until you get that bush in your paint or on your hand. All right, now come up here. Let's see here. Just touching. Maybe cuts in front. I like that. Very good. All right. Now we'll go into this color. Actually, I'm gonna use a little more red. A I'm sorry, a little pink. Something like that. Go back to the golds. One more yellow. Maybe this guy is going to be here. Stuck behind him a wee bit. Here, back here is going to be a little softer. Maybe a bush or two is peering through. Darker. Good. All right, I'm going to come to this other side. Ochre, little Indian yellow. Again, get that nice bush in your paint. And that's what we got in the bristles. All right, let's come over here. Maybe the sun's coming through and popping this guy right here. Again, we're just touching. See how the paint comes right off? Perfect. This guy's here. Like that. Like it. Get a little red in there. Darken it just a little bit. Just a touch of sun is shining through there. Oops, I got a little hair on there. Screw off. There we go. Okay, very good. And maybe we'll plop a little bit of growth here on that rock coming over. Make a little bush on this side of the tree over that rock. Maybe these colors come down a wee bit. Couple little grassy things. Chuck a couple back here. Alright. A little bit of this darker highlight. Maybe on the side of this rock we got a little growth. Right there. Do that tree first before we do anything over here. But I like this. Maybe back in here there's just a little indication of something. Maybe back in there. Just a little bit poking through. All right, just darkening up our tree here. Redefining the edges a little bit. make this board get kind of fat. Just filling this in. Some more color. Big rooty tree down here. This in too, just darkening these trees. Disappear in there. Very good. Okay, I think that is good. Take a clean filbert brush. I can find it. There we are. Just to blend out this dark into light. There we are. Touch up, add a little bit of foliage in here. It's going to be a little darker on this side. Just a couple pieces down here. Comes down between the rocks. There we go. All right, and with this brown and white, I'm just going to kind of coat both sides on that filbert brush. And we're just going to highlight the edges, just dragging. Or use the side, however you'd like. Leave dark in between your little strokes. Just letting the paint, kind of like the paint on the mountain, just letting it kind of break. Remember, this side of the tree is going to be darker than this side. Just a little up here, not much. The tree comes together, just a touch. Dull that down. All right, kind of a knobbly tree there. I'm going to take some of this color from the bushes, kind of with a little bit of that brown in it, a little bit of that ochre. You can experiment with it, and maybe we'll just touch. Hold on. A little more color on the tips of the bristles. And again, we're just letting the paint break. Just like on the mountains, but with the filbert brush. Dull that a little. Just keep rubbing it. Good. Take that same color. We'll come over here and just graze the edge of this tree. Oops. And we'll dull that down. There we go. Maybe just a little bit back here. A couple spots. Come back with a the dry filbert and just blend this up a wee bit. Take some of that color down. There we go. Same thing here, just lightly drag it. Good. Wipe that off. Come back with that filbert. Grab some of that color again. Maybe under here, we'll go with the brown. Both sides on a little bit of this ochre mix. Just a little bit. We'll come over here and touch. First, we'll maybe touch this one. And again, we're just dragging it down the tree. Be real loose with it. Just going to highlight this edge. Just about like that. It's not much you need to do on these trees. Oops, a little heavy. We can take care of that. Same thing there. Maybe just a little sunshine's hitting the trunks there. I like that. Touch a little yellow over this. Very good. Now we'll go back to that filbert, the clean one. I'm going to drag this up, or you could do it down, either way, just to diffuse it a little bit. It looks like some light hitting those trees there, a little darker on this one. I'm also fan brush. Since we have this big tree here and the sun is here, probably going to get a shadow that comes along here. So we're going to dip into some dark paint. And we are just going to kind of darken up. So it'll be a little wider here. Get more paint. A little wider. And then this shadow will stretch down. And just tapping kind of where we think that might go. Here we go. A little more on this side. This is going to go more like this. This side. A little more color. A little more dark. Come this way a little bit. A little more here. A little more this way. Now we can come back with our highlight brush and fix the edges of this a little bit. So you just put a little bit of stuff in here, just on the edge. Comes in like that. Just a little bit. And then we can also come on this side. And it might spill over here and there, just to break up the line. There, that's a little better. So now we got that shadow kicking back from that tree. I'm just filling this area a little bit with some light color. Like there is something there behind for that shadow. I'm going to do the same thing a little bit here. Up tree is a little bright. So we can come in here and we think that shadow might be. It's just darkening it up. That's it. Just need a little shadow there, and that's good. Okay, again, take our color with the golds, and we will gently just touch in a couple very lightly. It's going to be a shadow there. All right, very good. I'm going to come up here. I'm going to add a little dark in here. Add some darks. here. And touch that up a little bit. All right. I'm going to bring the edge out of this tree just a little bit right here. Heavy. And then take our filbert and we can tone that down. I'm going to bring this one down just to leave that edge shining a little bit. I like that. That. And I think I'm going to touch this one just a little bit too. Maybe even a little bit on this side. Okay. We'll come back with our filbert. And lift this up a wee bit. Just to tame it. All right, I think I'm going to put I want a big old branch. Might have to get some more paint. I think we're going to bring a old crickety branch out of the side of this tree. So maybe he comes up here. Goes up like that. I need more paint. All right, a little more paint. And he comes off. Goes right off. A crookie tree. All right, get my liner brush. A little thinner. And go through that black. A little more thinner. All right, get that black real liquidy. We're just going to put a couple little limbs on this guy. So twist that brush. Twist it in the paint. Little point. Maybe this guy comes off. Paint. branch a little better. A few limbs here and there. Good. Load up that brush, and you can just drop these in wherever you'd like. And I think I might even add, where's my fan brush? Oh, here we go. All right, one more paint. Come up on here. I'm going to blend these together. I think I'm going to darken this crop just a little bit. Just to fill it in. Okay. Now we can come back and fix these up a little bit. I'm going to get my smaller filbert to highlight these. So we'll go through that brown mixture again with a little bit of that ochre flower mixture we had on the smaller filbert, kind of load up both sides, and then we will carefully drag down the inside this tree limb. Good. Maybe a little bit of that yellow on the outside. This one, and I'm just dragging that color down. Good. That's my brush. Okay, I'm going to go through just a touch of this ochre color, a little bit of thinner. We're just going to touch some of these branches. Down so I can steady the hand. Just a little bit. Be on the bottom. A little more color. Very good. Pull this down. All right. A little more of this color. A little more thinner. Just barely dipping into thinner. Barely anything. Just a little bit. A little bit of color on here. We'll touch a couple of these. A little more color. That's good. That one's good. Maybe a little on him. Good. All right, so sitting here looking, I do not like this. So I'm going to get rid of it. Watch this. We're going to take this bush right out carefully. Sometimes you just got to rip a little piece of paper towel. Piece in here. Wipe this bush away. I just didn't like this bush. He wasn't doing it for me. So we'll get rid of him. Just like that, he's gone. Okay, so we'll take a little dark and fill that back in. Alright, so just come in here and wherever our bush is going to be, add that dark again. Perfecto. Okay, now we're going to come back with our brush that had all the golds and the stuff on it. So let's grab that. And we're going to pop in a big old bush. Tapping in. Tapping that color in. So let's plop her in again. Make this a little better. I like that better. Good, good, good. Let's see here. Here we go into more straight yellow a little bit. Put a nice colorful bush right on his foot. So it's coming down hitting him. And then the other side of this tree is going to be very dark because of that shadow. So we'll just kind of like be very sparse with our bush here. Not much color. Barely anything back here. A little more as it comes through. So that'll be mostly in shadow there. And then pop in a little bit of this dark. There we go. Okay, so I'm feeling another branch on this big tree. Let's see what we got here. So this boy's gonna come off the tree here. Way too thick. All right, let's clean him up. Scrub over this thick branch. Too thick. That's better. So I'm going to come back with my fan brush. I'm back here where we had a couple of these little red, pinkish type leaves. Add a couple of these back. We add under here. There we go. Okay. Now back to our liner brush. Go back into this dark color. Form a few more limbs over here. Okay, a few more of these limbs. I think we'll be good. Let's shape this one a little better. Hook, air, right off. That's double trouble there. I think that might be good. Double check. All right, very good. Darken that trunk a little bit. All right. I like it. Okay. Now I'm going to highlight that little bit of trunk. Not too much. This is just going to be pretty dark over there. So a little again of that ochreish pink color that we are using. And we're just going to touch a few. Use my guide hand, a few of these. Darker over there, so I think we're pretty good with that. A little bit more right. here. Darker there. There, gone. Okay. Where did I miss? All right, got my other filbert again. Now we just want to tamper this down a wee bit. Ah, yeah, this one's a little better. Good. I think that is it. I think so. I think I'm going to sign this one. So to sign it, I'm going to use a little bit of my liquid white. That laid out here. Actually, you know what? No, we'll go in this pink. So a little bit of this pink color. Turn the bristles. Turn, turn, turn. Okay. So we'll come down here and in the shadow. Put a good old J. C. Okay, there she is. Thank you so much for painting along with me. Hope you had a good time. And we'll talk soon, you guys. Take care. All right. I hope you had fun with that. As much fun as I had making it. It's always a blast to paint for you guys. So please hit the subscribe button. You can follow me. Check my links below. At Jeff's Oil Painting. Facebook, TikTok, Instagram, and YouTube, of course. So, follow me, check out all my new videos, tutorials, and cool things that I'll have coming along here now and in the future. So look forward to painting with all you guys again. All the best, and we'll see you next time.